To the citizens of the United States, we are anonymous. A new cybersecurity bill poses a serious threat to our privacy, giving the government extraordinary powers to silence potential whistleblowers and activists that confront the powers that be. And these dangerous new powers will rid away the very transparency laws that took down SOTPA and CISPA. The last time the Senate considered such a wildly absurd cybersecurity bill was in July 2012, when it took up the Cybersecurity Act of 2012 called the Cyber Intelligence Sharing and Protections Act, dubbed CISPA. Now, they are at it again, calling it CISA, which stands for the Cyber Intelligence Sharing Act. This bill would create a massive loophole in our existing privacy laws by allowing the government to ask companies for voluntary cooperation in sharing information, including the content of our communications, for cybersecurity purposes. But the definition they are using for the so-called cybersecurity information is so broad, it could sweep up huge amounts of innocent Americans' personal data. If you are aware that your data is being shared by the federal government, you cannot do anything. You cannot sue. You cannot speak. Because they see you as a threat that needs to be silenced. Corporations are the main backbone of this bill. The federal government would share cyber threat info to corporations to let them know how to counter such attacks and behavior. Yet, in return, companies like Verizon or AT&T, for example, need to give the United States government customer data, not of specific people, but of everyone. Unlike CISPA, CISA would allow companies to maneuver trade agreements to share personal and confidential data that doesn't belong to them. They would share it with state, local, and federal law enforcement without the customer's consent, which in turn creates a backdoor wiretap to anyone that is a potential and imminent threat to the federal government. Everyone is a target. Companies hold the power to change this bill, not the people in D.C. Even if corporations place themselves within misconduct, legal sanctions will hold them. Such effect is problematic and unethical. The Fourth Amendment protects Americans' personal data and communications from undue government access and monitoring without suspicion of criminal activity. The point of a warrant is to guard that protection. CISA would circumvent the warrant requirement by allowing the government to approach companies directly to collect personal information, including telephonic or internet communications. Based on the new broadly drawn definition of cybersecurity information, instead of limiting the use of data collection to protect against actual cybersecurity threats, this bill will clearly target potential government whistleblowers and civil, political and human rights activists. It's clear that the law is an attempt to give the government more power to crack down on whistleblowers or insider threats. In popular bureaucratic parlance, the Obama administration has brought more leak prosecutions against government whistleblowers and members of the press than all previous administrations combined. Who are the creators of this bill? With no one's surprise, Senator Feinstein, former and current chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, and Senator Saxby Chambliss are the ones deemed worthy to create such a horrible bill that would only step civil liberties backward instead of forward. CISA will also be held as a classified bill that would overturn any open records request or FOIAs. This would destroy our chance as citizens to revise this bill, or better yet, destroy it. The next hearing will be July 4th. Although this bill is not getting any media coverage, we will investigate further, along with other bills that have been abused, such as the National Defense Authorization Act and the authorization for use of military force. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.